Hello, I'm Jonathan Moyes, Head of Investment Research at Wealth Club, and today I'm with Mark Pearson of Fuel Ventures to talk about their EIS and SEIS funds. So hello Mark, welcome back to the studio. Firstly, for those who aren't familiar, could you give us some background to Fuel Ventures and your own experience?
Yeah, really happy to. We really offer a unique proposition. We come from an entrepreneurial background, which I think makes us pretty unique. I am an entrepreneur. I built and exited my own company over 8 years. That was in the digital space. And I think being able to do that and being able to look at other founders and entrepreneurs in the eyes when we're talking to them, you know, at the same time, we want them to take our money. And, you know, compare that to other funds or other investors they may be talking to, it does really give us an advantage because we can help them. We've been in the same space. And if I take a little step back, Fuel Ventures is 8 years old now. We've established ourselves as one of the leading players, one of the fastest growing players in the space. We have over 150 portfolio companies. We fully focus on tech and digital, which I think gives us a real unique proposition and offer. We've grown a team of nearly 30 people, which I'm really proud of. Non-stop momentum. I think there's a lot of exciting things happening what we're doing.
And so we're here today to talk about the EIS and SEIS funds. What do they aim to do for investors?
Yeah, we operate multiple funds, and I think that's a key strategy for us. We haven't rushed into doing the funds too quickly. We've added them over the course of the years as they've become relevant. So we started out as a seed investor, which is an EIS proposition, and then we launched our pre-seed, which is an SEIS fund, and now we have follow-on funds as well. So we have the ability to back companies from the very early stages all the way through, and I really think personally that adds a unique advantage to us, because in the UK tech market we're able to invest in companies across the spectrum. These early stages, you know, they can be very, very early stages, a pitch deck, first revenues. We double down into these companies. We follow them at an EIS, at a scale-up fund is what we call it. And then we do follow-on so we can back our winners again. So we're really just focusing on tech and digital businesses that we think have the potential to scale massively. And I don't say that loosely. We really are ambitious. We want founders and entrepreneurs that can build very big global businesses. That's really important to what we do. We're not after small multiples. We want to deliver outsized returns.
And typically, how much are you investing at each stage of those funds, at SEIS, scale up, follow on? What's the typical sort of round size for each of those?
Okay, so the tickets that we'll write and the round sizes can be a little bit different, but at the SEIS fund, we're doing £250,000 tickets on average. The round sizes can be anything from £500,000 to £1 million. You know, that's enough to start a company and really build a product and prove it. At our EIS fund, so our scale-up fund, we do anything from £1 to £3 million tickets, which is a really good size seed ticket for a company that's already got product, already got revenue, and ready to really scale that company. These companies need a decent amount of capital if they're really going to grow and become ambitious big companies. And then we have a follow-on fund where we pick the very best from the portfolio, and we invest probably £2 to £5 million on average, which is then doubling down into the winners. Remember, we sit on the boards of these companies, we see regular monthly metrics, and we're able to pick the winners and double down into them. So that excites me the most. It's a unique proposition to follow the companies through their journey.
So what are you looking for in these companies?
What we're looking for, super ambitious founders and entrepreneurs. I kind of look for people similar to myself. I've always been super hardworking, super ambitious. Actually, I'm lucky I found people that are way more ambitious and way more smarter than me. My team work alongside me to filter thousands of deals a year. And really, we're doubling down into the tech and digital space. So these are companies that are highly scalable. We want them to scale internationally. We invest in software companies, we invest in marketplaces, and we invest in platforms. So really, that's what we do. We stick to what we do, and we do it pretty well.
And so how do you, well, before you invest in these companies, you've got to find them. How do you source these investments?
We've been really lucky over the years. We've built a great reputation. We've built a really good following on LinkedIn. We've built a really good LP, a very large LP network. I think we've got over 1,000 LPs now. And all of that together, added with our pre-seed fund, our SEIS fund, which has lots of smaller early stage companies, and also other later stage VCs know our reputation in the market. So we have deal flow from lots of sources. We're spoiled for choice, to be honest. I think we looked 5,000 or 6,000 deals coming in per year. And you know, we're only investing in around 40 deals a year. So if you think of what that funnel looks like, I really say myself, we're looking for the diamonds in the dust. Unfortunately, for a lot of companies out there, we will say no an awful lot. And the quality criteria is really high. So good for us isn't good enough. We want great, we want superb. And we're very fortunate to be able to do that. We move quickly and we lead a lot of our investment deals we do.
So talking about deals, can you give us a few examples of recent investments you've made in the funds?
Yeah, we've made some fantastic investments. We've got a portfolio of over 150, as I said, that continues to grow all the time. Some that'll come off the top of my head, a company called Vault, an open banking digital payments business. We invested in it over 3 years ago. That company's sitting at a 32 times uplift for our investors already. I think that's pretty exciting. It shows when you get it right, these companies can really scale. Another company is called Shift. It's a digital platform for logistics for very large items. They work with a lot of big retailers. I think that one's sitting at a 23 times multiple. So another significant good performer for us. And then another company called OnBuy, an e-commerce marketplace, company we're really proud of. We backed really early. That one's sitting at a 14 times multiple. The multiples I quote are still on the journey. You know, that these companies we expect to continue for the next 2, 3, or 4 years. We're not a short-term investor. We like to invest for the medium long term. So I get excited if we've already achieved that much multiple. There's hopefully still a lot more to go. But that's the size of the ambition we aim for. But there's a lot more companies underneath the portfolio that are performing well as well.
And any recent examples? So I guess those are three good examples of established holdings within the fuel portfolio, but more recently?
More recently, we've invested in a company called Correcto from our pre-seed fund. This is a prime example of where we see a company. Previously, we would only invest in companies with certain revenue and certain product development and pipeline. We've seen this company, we were really excited by it, and we invested from our pre-seed fund, our SEIS fund. This company's done really, really well, broken out very, very quickly. I think that's sitting on a 20 times. And then there's another company in the portfolio which excites me called Peckwater Brands. Essentially, it's a technology for restaurants and food delivery. The business is doing really, really well, and that recently got invested in by SoftBank. So, you know, a big name in the industry has followed in after Fuel Ventures.
And so, Mark, to what extent do you get involved in some of these companies? Obviously, being an entrepreneur yourself, part of the pitch must be that you're getting involved in helping these companies in some way.
Yeah, you're right. I think that's real passionate to us. So I only started Fuel Ventures all them years ago in the aim of finding the best entrepreneurs, the most ambitious entrepreneurs, and then backing them, investing in them, and then helping nurture them. It doesn't finish when you write a check and make your investment. That's actually where it all begins. You've got to roll your sleeves up. You've got to get actively involved. And as an entrepreneur myself, I know what that feels like. We can work side by side with these companies to really help them scale. So we're pretty hands-on across the board. Some companies need much more attention and support than others, and that's perfectly fine. But the ones that do need support, we help with fundraising. So we have a dedicated team to help them with fundraising. Big companies need capital. So we're a seed investor mainly, and we invest at the beginning. We need to be friends and have great relationships with other investors, so we really help create competitive rounds. We also have an in-house talent team where we help find the best employees and team members. Super important, the people in the company are the key to building that business. So we're supporting them there. We have regular board meetings. We take board seats, which I think is really, really important to help guide and steer the businesses. And there's lots of other things. We have a community of, I think, nearly 200 founders now who share best resources, best ideas, best practices, regulation changes, law changes. So if you think of that community, there's a real big momentum there. Founders need help at all levels. It's really hard building a company. It's really hard scaling a company. But all of these things can help.
I guess having been there and done it, you've got a reasonable idea of what the founders are going through themselves.
It's hard. It's funny. I always try and put founders off at the very end of our conversation when we're about to write a term sheet. I always say, are you really ready for this journey? I know they are because they've already come that far, but I try and put them off. I say, it's grueling. It's really hard. You're going to know social life. You're probably going to break your relationship because you're just so dedicated. The real best entrepreneurs that I've seen in the space, some of the ones I've quoted today with some of these significant multiple uplifts, have gone through that dedicated journey for maybe 5 to 10 years of building a company. Normally, if you're building a global business, you're on a plane all the time, traveling and building, opening new offices and all the above. So I try and put them off. And actually, if they still come back fighting, I think they're the right type of people to back.
Very good. And so I guess the end goal is an exit. Any exits you can discuss from the portfolio?
Yeah, we've had a couple of exits now, and I think the level of maturity of our portfolio is really starting to show that now. So companies we invested in maybe 3 years ago or 5 years ago are coming up to that maturity level. So we sold Content Cal to Adobe, and that was, I think, an 8.8 something times return, which is fantastic. And then we also sold another company to Carter in the US, so a CapDesk, which was another great exit, and we returned cash to investors. So I'd say we're starting to see really good results here. I'm really proud of what we are achieving, but what's in the pipeline is even more exciting. These were early exits for us. Some of the numbers that I quoted earlier on some of the uplifts of our companies are what I'm really excited about, what's coming up in the future, hopefully.
So potentially some new exits on the way.
Yeah, the market's interesting. I think with a lot of US and, you know, a lot of big businesses that are well funded, they're looking always acquisitive opportunities. So we're always, as a fund, always looking at our companies and who's getting approached by what. We're in conversations now for potential exits. You can never promise, and the journeys obviously are two-sided, but it's always exciting. That's the game we're in. We're looking to exit our companies. We want to return capital to our investors. We're here to make investors money. That's what we're in. So it's exciting. It's part of the journey. Finding the companies, investing in the companies is just one phase of the whole project and investment. But actually getting the exits is the real sweet spot. And we as a team really double down. We help support that process. We help negotiate very hard. You know, we can be the back cop in the room. We're the one that needs to sign that deal off. So even in the Adobe example, when we sold Content Cal, we negotiated, we probably got double the price by negotiating really hard and being the bad cop. So, you know, we won't sell for X. And actually, it's a very hard negotiation to have, but it's really important. I'd say the experience now, I think I've had four exits myself over the course of my journey and career. But I think all the time you're learning new things, and you just know where that negotiation can be. And we put the right advisors and support network around us as well.
And so turning to risks, clearly some exits are great, but investing at such an early stage, pretty high risk. How risky would you say this part of the market is? And for, say, every 10 investments you make within your EIS funds, how many do you expect to fail?
Yeah, I think that's a really important point. We've got to mention risk. We are investing in early stage companies. The risk reward is there. So yes, I'm going to say there's risk. Of course, we will lose some companies. That's baked into our numbers and our expectations. But also we hope to win medium and big on other companies. So I would say on our SEIS fund, in our model, we expect a 50% failure rate, which sounds large, but these are early stage companies. Mm-hmm. We get it at the right price. We can afford to write off a lot of failures. That's expected for investors. But actually the ones that win can do very well because you're in a nice early low valuation. And on our EIS funds, we expect maybe a 20% failure rate. And we're doing well on that. We work really hard. We're hands-on. We sit on the boards. We help steer these companies. And even sometimes we can pivot the businesses or change the business models while they've still got investor cash in the bank. That doesn't happen a lot, but I'm telling you that so you know we're not just a passive investor. We're active, and if we don't see something working, we'll be hands-on and help shape it. And I think a good example in our portfolio is Fuel. It actually started out as a fashion marketplace, and now it's a consumer product, and it's doing very, very well. It went from struggling, failing to grow revenue. Now it's doing multi-millions in revenue, so I see we've salvaged and gained investor value, in my opinion.
And so finally, to sum up, Mark, for those that want to invest in an EIS fund or SEIS fund this year, why should they invest with Fuel Ventures?
I think that's a nice question. I think we're really an entrepreneurial fund. You know, the hands-on experience, the entrepreneurial experience that we've had really stands us up head and shoulders above the rest when founders choose us as an investor. And I think that's the key point. Founders do choose who they want as their investor. It's not just, I will take the money. The best founders, it's a competitive process, and we can give a really competitive pitch to them. We've invested in over 150 companies. We're well established now. We've got a great brand and great reputation in the industry. We've been recently listed as two of the best performing EIS funds on the market, which I think is fantastic. That's a lot of years of hard work to start for the industry to start to recognize. And overall, technology and digital are some of the fastest growing sectors. So if you like to invest in the fastest growing sectors in the world, I think we're a good fund for that.
Feels like a good place to end. Mark Pearson, Fuel Ventures, thank you very much.
Thank you.
If you're watching on YouTube, please press like and subscribe to the channel for more.